welcome back. My next guest is a military guy who's serving still with the Connecticut Army National Guard. He's a veteran of two combat tours in Afghanistan, 21 years in the infantry, and he's been a teacher at the Officer Candidate School. According to his bio, now he has entered the rough and tumble of politics as he seeks the Republican nomination for Congress in Eastern Connecticut. That's the second district where Democrat Joe Courtney has been serving for the last 14 years. And this morning, I want to welcome Justin Anderson to The Real Story to make his case. All right. Hasn't anybody told you about the advantage that incumbents have?
Yes, sir. They do have many advantages. Political funding being one of them, name recognition being another one. And Joe Courtney has been around for quite a while. But I don't think that he necessarily represents all the values that we have in the eastern side of Connecticut. And so I'm definitely here to challenge, some of the
values. What values are you talking about that you don't feel he's responded to?
Well, one, and it's going to be talked later on today, is definitely Second Amendment. There's a lot of Second Amendment personnel, people in the rural areas of eastern Connecticut.
Hunters and just people who enjoy going out and
a lot of gun
recreation.
Clubs, recreation shooting.
Yeah.
A lot of military personnel, too. Law enforcement personnel, Department of Corrections personnel who feel they have the
and
right
you were
to
in corrections, too.
Yes, sir. 20 years I spent in the maximum security prison. And today I go down to Crystal Mall. And, there are inmates that, used to be inmates who I run into at the mall. They say, hey, CO, which is, short for correction officer.
Right, right.
And they recognize me. I'm 6 foot seven.
It's hard to miss you.
Hard to miss
me. How tall are you?
6 foot seven.
6'7".
Yeah.
And which basketball team did you play for?
None. I played football for Middletown
High.
Middletown High football team. Yes, sir.
Did you have a good team?
It was best, actually, at that time frame, we were undefeated. Nobody could beat Middletown back when I was in high school.
All right. You've made a point. I've seen your Facebook page. You make a point about being sort of disgusted with politicians on both sides because they're creating the divisions that we have seen, the extreme divisions, the tribal nature of politics.
It has become tribal. There's a lot of stuff that I think we can agree on. Unfortunately, what you're seeing in politics is because everyone wants to stay in power. Each party wants to stay in power. In order to do that, they're essentially taking the American people, they're getting into their heads, and they're kind of pulling apart on ideology, which is, when you think about it, we can come together on a lot of topics, we can come closer together on a lot of topics, and I don't think the political parties are trying to do that. So the goal is to, reach the public, come to a closer consensus on what benefits the majority of the people. It's not always the same thing. People have, different ideology. Like I said, gun control, some people want gun control, some people don't. But then you got to look at your areas. I know for my area, gun control is a bigger issue, and a lot of people, feel like we're over restricted in Connecticut.
So besides gun control, what other issues do you feel you feel you're superior to the positions that Joe Courtney has taken?
One that may play in my favor, you coming from the DOC or Department of Corrections, is if you look at single payer health care. That's going to eliminate health care for all Americans and put us under one system. So there's a lot of people, especially DOC, state police, who have worked many years, have been in a lot of dangerous situations to essentially earn that medical care. So if you put it into a single payer system, everyone's in the same system and they lose the health care that
they really think that's going to happen?
I mean, I don't see how.
I mean, it's looking like Joe Biden is going to win the Democrat nomination. Of course, we still don't know how the election itself is going to turn out with President Trump. Do you think he would win this time around?
I mean, honestly, it's looking like it's leaning in Joe's favor. I personally think either one is going to have a hard time beating Donald Trump, and a lot of it comes down to ideology. Either one, my biggest concern when you look at Joe Courtney is well over 90%, close to 95%, he goes down the party line. So whoever's leading the party, if it is Bernie Sanders, then I fully believe he's going to go for single-payer health care. So the goal of that is not to have Bernie Sanders the president, unless all those people who work for their health care lose it.
If Bernie Sanders isn't there, do you think that Joe Biden would be in favor?
I don't. In that case, I don't.
So
we don't know who's running yet.
Who's going to win yet? Toward Joe Biden right now.
I believe so. But we got to look at the debates, too, because I honestly believe Bernie Sanders seems a little bit sharper.
How would you, Joe has been big with the submarine industry down there. I mean, obviously that's important to Connecticut, it's important to the nation. Do you see yourself getting into, being an infantry guy, getting into a submarine?
Well, I've been in a submarine. I don't really fit well. The reality is he gets a lot of credit for what's going on at the sub base.
Do you think he's not deserved? Not deserving of that credit?
I mean, I'm an officer in the military. I go to NGB a lot. I work with the military. I know the whole background and the mechanics.
What's NGB?
National Guard Bureau.
Oh, National Guard Bureau.
They oversee all the National Guards of all the states throughout the country.
Okay.
But the reality is 2 years ago, the Navy knew how many submarines they need. You know, so whatever's being built this year, they knew last year. It's really the needs of the Navy. It's the needs of the military. And the reality is, and this is kind of the funnier portion of it, is Donald Trump is rebuilding the military. So really, if you want to give credit to anybody, I'd give it more to Donald Trump than to Joe Courtney, because if you have a strong military, the funds that go into that and the Navy needs that we can support are going to come down, you know, through the presidency and where he puts it. If we cut back the military, then we cut back the funding, we cut back what we can do for the military. So either way, Joe Courtney has less to do with that than...
What do you say to people who say, the president has put his emphasis on the military, maybe being strong militarily, but at the same time, he's willing to take money from defense to go put on the wall, you know, to finish that wall. Where are you on immigration?
Those two different topics right there. As far as the wall, I'll touch it real quick. I mean, we spent a lot of money, and the Corps of Engineers went down to New Orleans, you know, during Katrina. We've done that many times in the past. The media just doesn't publicize it. Right now, Donald Trump's the president, so they publicize it. They try and make him look bad, I believe. So that's always been done. The reallocation of funds is something that the military does all the time. Quite honestly, I've gone to other states and found money that other states haven't used specifically for specific projects and have reallocated it to Connecticut. I've got some friends in where I work up over here in Hartford who are good at that. I've gone with them and we've gotten these funds back to Connecticut. So funds aren't always properly reallocated, and if that money's not used, it just goes back to the government.
All right.
So the reality is a lot of times those funds are there. So when we talk about reallocation of funds, even when it's coming from the military, the reality is there's a lot of times there's money there that's not going to be used. So we could, you know, change the story or the narrative, but the money's quite often there.
All right. Justin Anderson, Republican for Congress in the 2nd District. Thanks for being here on the show.
Thank you. Thanks for having me, sir.
Sure. Up next here on The Real Story, nobody likes to have to pay a tax, right? Least of all, perhaps gun owners who are now faced with the prospect of paying a hefty excise tax on ammunition they buy. What's behind this tax? And what's the gun lobby doing about it? We'll take it to the top, the new leader of that lobby, Holly Sullivan, in a moment. Stay with us.